My name is Dr.Asmr. Have you been here for a while? Oh, okay. The waiting room does fill up a little bit sometimes. We want all of our patients to be well cared for and looked after and give them the time that they deserve, so sometimes the waiting room does fill up a little bit. You weren't there too long? Okay, good. Well, I will give you a checkup and we'll try to figure out how to help you and how to make you feel a little bit better. So just sit back and relax. And I'll take care of you. Is it okay while I'm assessing that I touch you just a little bit? Yes? Okay. This is my doctor's bag that has all of the supplies I will be using and the medical equipment. I like to explain to you beforehand what's going on so that you feel safe and comfortable. This doctor's bag has been in my family for quite a few years. My parents were physicians, and now I am, and they've passed it down to me. Has a really lovely texture. And it's held up very well over the years, as you can see. A nice strong handle here. Got some very nice fabric here. Do you want to tell me what happened? Are you hurt? Yes, okay. On a scale of 0 to 10, if 10 is the worst pain that you could ever have, and 0 is no pain at all, what would you say that your pain is right now? Okay. Would you like any medicine for that right now? No. You want to wait a little bit? Sure. Just let me know, and I'll ask you again before our assessment is finished, just in case you need it. So first, I'm just going to get your blood pressure. Like I said, I'd like to explain everything so that you know what to expect. So this is where the reading is. I'll be able to see what your blood pressure is on here. This will go around your arm, just secured with a bit of Velcro. Like so. We'll just put this around your arm. And then, I will use this little piece here. I'll just give it a squeeze on your arm, and this part will tighten a little bit around your arm. You'll feel it tighten, and then it will loosen, and I will get my reading. And it will look like this. along with the blood pressure cuff, I use the stethoscope so that I can listen to the sounds in conjunction with using this to get your blood pressure reading. So let me take that out, get it ready. So here's my stethoscope. Before I take your blood pressure, I'll just listen to your lungs and your heart and your stomach sounds. Alright. So I'm just going to put this on your chest. Can you take a deep breath in? And out. Good. Another deep breath in and out. Good. Other side. Deep breath in and out. Other side, in and out. Great. Now I'll just listen to your heart. Okay, sounds good. And then I'll just listen to the sounds in your abdomen. Just listen to the little gurgles in your stomach. Just make sure everything is working properly there. I listen to all four quadrants. And I'm just listening for little gurgling sounds. Sounds like everything is working just great there. Perfect. Okay, so now I can get your blood pressure. I really like how colorful our blood pressure cuff is here. I think it gives the patients just a little bit of comfort, a little more to look at while they're being assessed. Not so whitewashed and sterile, if you know what I mean. Everything is clean. But it doesn't give you that sterile feeling of it being all white when it's so colorful. So I'll just put the cuff on this arm. Perfect. And then I'm going to also listen to your pulse while I take this blood pressure. Okay, your blood pressure is perfect. Just take this off. And take my stethoscope off for now. Good. So, you You said you were rollerblading and you had a bit of a fall. Okay. And you have some soreness in your other arm? Okay. Oh yes, I see just a little bit of swelling there. So what I think I'm going to do is I'll send you for an x-ray. And then when you're back, we'll review the x-ray together. Yes, and then we'll come up with a treatment plan. Okay, I'll send you that way, and I'll see you in a few minutes. Good. Okay, you're back. How was it? Not too bad. Oh, good. And you found your way through to the x-ray room? Okay. Yes? Okay, good. While we're waiting for those results, it does take a little bit of time for the x-ray to be read. I have a few more things that I would like to assess, and then we'll have the whole picture. We like to get a very thorough picture of what's going on, so that we can help you as best we can. So, I think the next thing that I would like to check are your reflexes. So, I just have this little reflex hammer here. And what I do is I just slightly tap each one of your knees. And just see what your reflex is like. If you give a little kick with your foot, and it should just happen naturally. Okay? Nope, it won't hurt. Okay. So I'll do this knee first. Ready? One, two. Okay, good. And now this one. How's that arm feeling? It's getting a little bit more sore. Okay, I have some medicine I can give you. We can even give it as a shot if you like. It will just work a little more quickly. Okay, so that's good. Going to put it into right here. Yep. Just a little poke. Okay, ready? And there. Yep. You barely felt it? Oh, great. And it looks like we almost have the results from your x-ray. I see you have a few little scratches on that arm from where you took your fall and where you're having the pain. I could put a couple little band-aids on it if you like. Yeah, just at the top there. There's a few little scratches. Would that help you feel a little bit better, do you think? Okay. Let's try that. So I think these ones will do. Yep, these are bandages. Etch-A-Sketch, as you can see. They're a very high quality bandage. So it should be soothing and also help heal the scratches. Exactly. We use this brand a lot in our hospital clinic, Fisher-Price. And there are a couple left. There's one, and I think we'll use the two that are left in here. So you'll see that it's just looks like this. It's quite soft. A little bit porous so that your skin can still breathe a bit through the bandage. And this one's slightly larger, not by much. But just slightly, as you can see. Alright, so I'll go and apply those now. Good. And then this one too. This refilled. I like to have lots of stock on hand. So now that we have most of the assessments done that we need, I'd just like to ask you about your pain again now that you've had a little bit of medicine for the pain. And a couple of bandages. How is your pain now? A little bit better? Okay, good. On a scale of 0 to 10. If 10 is the worst pain you could ever have, and 0 is none, what would you say it is? Okay, so it's getting better. You still have some pain. Alright, well, we'll be taking a look at the x-ray and see what it says. And then that will determine our treatment plan from here. Are you thirsty? I know you've been waiting a while. You are? Okay. Can I offer you some tea or some juice? Perhaps we have. I can show you actually. Here we have some orange juice. It's very sweet and delicious. And it's what's in the fridge, so it's still cold. And then we also have some tea. I can make you tea, if you like. This is our tea kettle. It is really cute, isn't it? What do you think? You'd like some orange juice? Sure. No problem. Just put this back. And I'll just get some of this sweet, delicious orange juice ready for you. And then I'll just set your cup over there. Sure. Enjoy. And it looks like our x-ray report is back. I'll just take a look at that. Yes, I've taken a look at the x-ray. And it looks like you have just a tiny fracture just right in your arm there, just a little bit beneath where the bandages are. So you have the scratches at the top, and then just below it, you just have bone with a little bit of fracture. It should heal nicely if I get a cast on it. Exactly. Do you have any questions about that? Yep, it'll just take me a few minutes to put that cast on. Mm-hmm. And then you go home with it, and then I can see you in a few weeks and we can check it again, and perhaps the cast can come off at that time. Exactly. Okay, I can just get that ready. How does that sound to you? Sounds like a plan. Okay, good. So, it's not a very big fracture, and it won't take a very huge cast. So, I'd like to fancy up this cast a little bit before I put it on you, if that's okay. Mm-hmm. Like I said, we like things a little more colorful here. Just makes the experience a little bit better. So, I think I will write, get well. Because I would be so happy for you to get well, and I'm sure you would too. So, just grab my pen. And I'm going to write, get well, and I'll draw a little picture on it. And I'll even put a little tic-tac-toe. So if you'd like to play tic-tac-toe with any of your friends, you can. There we are. There's the little tic-tac-toe. And you can finish playing this game on your cast with your friends. Doesn't that sound fun? And then, here's the get well that I wrote, and the little picture. And when you're ready, let me know, and I'll just apply your cast to your arm. You ready now? Okay. Here it comes. I just smooth it out. Just gonna smooth it out. Alright, there. That's great. How is your pain now? Oh, it feels even better with the cast. Oh, that's wonderful. Okay. You are good to go now. If your pain gets any worse, or you have any concerns, just call my office at any time. And I can help, and we can figure out any of your concerns. Hopefully, though, it'll be pretty event-free, and you'll just heal nicely, and I'll see you in a few weeks. Exactly. Okay. Thanks so much for coming in, and I hope you get well soon.